Music You Can See, we're with Pam Taylor at Dirt Shack Studios. Hi, Pam.
Hey, how you doing?
Real good. So you've come off of a very long late night last night at the Mint in LA. You won 2 LA Music Critic Awards. Talk about that.
Well, so I didn't even realize that I had been nominated until I had won. And the guy who, Bob Leggett, who's the LA Music Critic, and another guy named Doug Deutsch, and he reached out to me and said that's how he had found out about me whenever I was nominated, and he let me know he'd voted for me. I said, voted for me for what? And my promoter, Lean Veltis, from another Blues Is Knockin', had submitted my record to Bob for review, and that's how it got nominated, and I didn't even know. So that's one of those blessings that just kind of happened, you know. When I found out they were doing the award showcase in L.A., and they invited me to come and perform and accept the awards, and I wasn't in a financial position to fly out here. And I was doing an interview for Music Mafia Radio, and they were asking me about the awards and asked me was I going to come out here. And I said, you know, I don't think it's a good time for me to come out there financially. And they're like, wait a minute, what? You got to go out there. So they did this fundraiser through their website. Oh. What they did was they announced that they were going to be doing the fundraising, so they were asking for artists or whoever to donate CDs or T-shirts to do these prize packages to make an incentive for the people to donate the money. And they were going to run it for 2 weeks. Well, within the first week, we'd raised the goal of $1,000 because of the support. And it was other artists from Music Mafia Radio that were donating the money.
Wow.
Which was huge. So it's a huge supportive community of musicians and Music Mafia Radio, and I'm so grateful. I've never had anything like that before happen, and it was just amazing. And more like Mike Bauer, he's the assistant deputy district attorney, and he's also a Music Mafia artist.
Oh, wow.
And when he found out that I was coming out here, offered me a place to stay. So there was a free place to stay, and they paid for my plane trip out here. And last night was the award show, and I kicked it off. And you know, I love doing that because I feel like I set the tone for the rest of the night with my positive vibes. And it was just a wonderful night. I loved hearing all the other artists because they were artists I've never heard of before. And that's another blessing to come out here and network is a huge thing. I didn't have a whole lot of gigs lined up, but, you know, things kind of fall into place when you allow the universe to work its magic.
Wow, as competitive as the music industry is, and then to see how supportive your fellow artists are is amazing.
I know, it blows my mind. But, you know, everybody says that. And you know what? I think it all depends on your perspective on what the universe shows you. I don't believe that it's competitive. I don't believe that it's a hard business. So it's not. It's been really easy and I feel like if you're following your heart and you follow your bliss, it's got to be easy. And that's just my perspective on life in general. You know, if you believe what everybody tells you, people who might have had a negative experience, don't let them cloud your experience by theirs. And the showcase was actually at the world-famous Mint in Los Angeles. And the amazing musicians that had graced that stage, it didn't even really hit me until after I had gotten off the stage that I was standing in the same spot as, you know, Frank Sinatra or, you know, so many great artists.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so it is very surreal. And I feel like I pinch myself on a daily basis to remind myself that this is really happening. And it's, you know, following your dream sometimes feels like you're in a dream. But yeah, letting to play the Mint was huge.
Which 2 awards did you receive there?
Blues Artist of the Year, and then I made a really risque, sexy Christmas music video, and it won Best Holiday Music Video.
Wow!
And it was a gift from a friend of mine, and it was really inspiring because it was a gift, and it was the first award he won as a videographer.
Wow! So it's a double whammy.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
And your next upcoming gigs, talk about your, you have a record out first.
I do, Steal Your Heart. It came out in September, and I went on a world tour, and I had my CD release party in Israel, of all places.
Nice.
And I'm going to have a CD release party for my hometown of the Queen City in September when I get back home, September 21st at the Rabbit Hole.
So you're basically still on tour.
Yes, it seems like this whole time has been one big tour, you know,
wow.
And I'd like to do it in increments, go tour for a little bit and then come spend some time at home and then go back out. So this kicks off this tour, this West Coast tour. So tomorrow I have a show at the Grafton at Bar 20 with the artist Mike Bauer,
okay.
And he's got a great lineup. It's like an acoustic stripped down version, so I'll be doing my solo set, and he's got his backup singers, and you know, it's just going to be really low key, but you know, I'm excited about it. And then I head on up the West Coast. I'm playing with Val Starr outside of Sacramento at the Acoustic Den in Roseville, California.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then I head on up to Portland, where I team up with Ray Gordon and Dave Million, and I'm doing some gigs with Ben Rice. I'm doing a Gospel Sunday brunch thing with her, and then doing a couple jams after the Waterfront Blues Festival. And then I'm playing Mekong Bistro on July 11th with Ben Rice and Dave Fleshner, who was keys player for Curtis Salgado. So I'm really excited about networking with all these great musicians while I'm here.
Nice.
And then
nice.
I head back home in July and got some great stuff putting a band together to do my CD release party in September.
And where's home?
Lancaster, South Carolina. So I'm right on the state line. So I'm a Carolina girl because I've, you know, anything to do is in Charlotte, North Carolina,
right.
Which is like the closest big city. So I think that's why everybody's like North Carolina, South Carolina. That's all me.
And woo!
Woo! Yeah.
What's your website so we can get your CD and find out where you're playing?
PamTaylorMusic.com. And Pam Taylor Music is my handle on all social media. I have a YouTube channel, just released a brand new music video for my single Nirvana. So go check it out. I'm doing a giveaway on my tour. So if you subscribe and like and share my YouTube channel, you'll be entered to win a prize package with some of my signed CDs, posters, and some of my Stolen Hearts jewelry that I make. That's another.
Oh, wow. So you create the jewelry.
I do. Stolen Hearts Creations by Pam, a song you can wear.
Wow. Nice. Well, it's been a pleasure. We're at the Dirt Shack in Arcadia, California.